Morning, Andoni.
Good morning.
Have you had the chance to look back, reflect, and enjoy the victory against Arsenal at the weekend? Because it was a statement victory. I know there was a red card in the game, but you still had to go and win it. You've seen Arsenal this season go down to 10 men and still pick up 3 points or still pick up a point. So have you had a chance to enjoy those moments?
Well, we've done the same process we do all the weeks. At the end, review the game, especially the first 30 minutes that we played 11 against 11, where is the most usual scenario, and learn also from there, and focus on Villa. We haven't really paid much more attention. At the end, we all the weeks, more or less, we follow the same process, the same workflow, and it has been the same this week.
A lot's been made of the Ryan Christie goal. Jamie Carragher said it's the goal of the season so far. There was some analysis on Sky Sports News on Monday Night Football, the way that you've watched Arsenal in the first half and then identified potential weaknesses with their zonal marking, and then you put it into practice, then you've made a load of substitutes and still been able to get that information into the players to go and execute that corner perfectly. Are you surprised at the level of attention that goal has got, and does that now make you under more pressure to try and be creative moving forward because people know what you do?
It doesn't surprise me, but it's true that we scored not as pretty but very similar routine against QPR in the FA Cup past season. Nobody talked about that goal, you know, but it's what it is. When you do things against this kind of opposition, everyone is paying more attention. I think we scored also a very good routine against Forest. First game, it was disallowed, but I think we are doing good stuff. I think we've had also another three set play goals disallowed, Leicester, Newcastle here, the Dangos one, the Forest we speak. Probably we were not getting all the value in the things we were doing offensively in set plays, and I think it's good. It's good to score because I think we are creating danger, we are being a threat, and probably we don't have the numbers we should considering the threat we are creating. No, I'm happy also defensively, set plays, touch wood, but we are defending really, really well, and I hope, no, because this change very quickly, we can continue, no, because this is about especially focus and discipline about the players. Everyone do your job, don't forget the small details, the small things, and sometimes you need one goal just to reinforce the message, and everyone look how important it is to do this small block, to do this small thing, because it's the only way to make these things work, yes.
Can you give us an insight into the half-time dressing room situation? Because as a manager, you've got to think of the bigger picture, you've got to think about the players, maybe how to change the tactics, and that is where the set-piece coach becomes even more important, because he can then look at that side of the game and how to affect the second half.
No, it's already in the bench in the first half. Once they go with 10, obviously it's a good chance to take corners short, because it's the best way to use this advantage that you have, no? One more player, especially considering their physicality. It's very difficult to win aerial balls against them because they are all very tall. So it was a good moment. We prepared a couple of plays, and this time it worked. We did it against other opposition, you know, but you don't score, probably doesn't have this attention.
Obviously some bad news this week with Alex Scott, who's had surgery. Can you just give us an update on what happened and the process that he's gone through since the injury?
Yeah, it has been it's always a bad moment, no, when you have something like this, but especially after, I think, a very good performance from Alex. He trained next day, but after training he was feeling pain on the knee. He went to do the MRI, and we could see, no, he had a tear in the meniscus. The doctors decided to have surgery and decide in the moment, no, if it was something that could be repaired, or just in other cases they remove one part, so it's worse. If they remove it, worse for him in the mid-long term. It's maybe the period where he's out is shorter, but considering his age, if there was a chance to repair the meniscus, it it was a clear decision, and I think the surgeon has took the right decision. Luckily, they could repair the meniscus. That probably is going to be much better for him mid long term. But it's true that he will be out more time now in the short period. Yes.
Have you got a period of time? Is it 4 weeks, 6 weeks,
no,
12 weeks?
No, definitely more. Definitely more than six. 6 weeks was probably if they remove the meniscus. If they repair it, and you have to wait more because now he has to be some time without doing anything, and will be more, but I don't know how much. Yes.
And other team news ahead of the weekend? Have you got any other concerns about players or players coming back?
Yeah, Sini is not going to travel. It's not nothing big, but he was with some issues after the game also against Arsenal, and probably he will be available next week, or if it's not City, it's going to be Brentford, but he's not going to travel for the game against Villa, yes.
And obviously, you've come off the back of this Arsenal game, big result, Saturday night football, a lot of attention on you, 11 points on the board. How do you now replicate that kind of a performance against an Aston Villa side who are having a brilliant season themselves?
Nah, Aston Villa, they are playing very, very, very well. They are having great results. They come on a great run of, I think, performances and results. That is always difficult. They have also almost everyone available, so for sure they are very dangerous. But we have to be at the same level we were here against Arsenal, or better if we want to take something from the game. No, we have the experience. I think past season we played two good games. Probably second half of the away game was not so good, but the other three halves, let's say, were good against them. Goals for both teams, quite open games. And I expect a little bit the same for tomorrow, yes.
How much do you think the fact that they've played in the Champions League this week will take out of their players, because it's the highest level of club competition and they're up against some of the best teams in Europe, and playing two, three games a week can really be a challenge?
No, I think it will take zero from them. I think we've experienced it past season. They also played even worse because they played Thursday, because they played the Conference League, I think, past season, and they were very good against us, at the top of their physicality. I think we've talked about this. They have a way of playing where they control very good the tempo of the games. They use very well the keeper. They have the patience to build up, to wait for the spaces to appear, and then obviously their players up front are all different makers. And they deal very well with these things, and they have also a full squad, so I expect the best version of Villa. And we also have to be very, very close to our best if we want to have a chance.
And just finally for me, you've got 11 points on the board after 8 games. At this stage last season, you had just 3 points on the board. What does that say about the progress you've made as a club, and how much you're looking to try and take the club to the next level and push forward?
Yeah, obviously we know each other much better. I think everyone has more clear their roles, but it's still very early in the season. You know, we've had quite logical results. If you change the Leicester points for the Arsenal points, probably we've been there where we wanted, or what was expected. But we have to continue, because now we're talking Villa, City, Brentford away. You know, it doesn't get any easier. And if we want to continue there, we have to be very good. And now also we lose Alex, we lose Sini for tomorrow. We've been very, I would say, quite lucky until now with the injuries in this season, and now probably it will be chance for other players also to help us, yes.
Thank you.
With Alex's injury, how well timed is it, if you like, that Tyler is now back in the squad?
I don't know if it's one for the other. You know, it's not, I wanted both. You know, but it's true that it's probably the best moment for Tyler, no, to start getting the minutes. I think he's feeling well. He's feeling confident in trainings. is the most important thing after a long time with different issues. I think now I see him playing very freely, and I think he's ready to contribute straight away, yes.
How much can he contribute? Is he looking at sort of a half hour, 20 minutes, or could he play a half or longer?
Obviously, he cannot play 90 minutes right now straight away after a lot of time out, but I think it's a matter of seeing the feelings he has, no? If one day plays 30, no issues, he can train next day normal, so we will go increasing or not, depending the needs also of the team, but nobody has told me, no, the restrictions are this and this. No, it's going to be a little bit like the feelings we all have, especially him.
Marcos Senesi, there's talk in Argentina that the national coach is keen to recall him after a couple of years out. How impressive for you has he been over these 15 months?
Yeah, Marcos has been playing very, very well. Very well, and improving a lot, I think, since the beginning, no? Because I think the way we want to play, I think it fits very well with his strengths. And now you can see, no, that he's very comfortable, even going out of position sometimes. It's not easy for some center backs to lose the position the same way he does and keep the confidence and not be out of place. But he's very good in doing these things, and I'm sure. Obviously, he plays for a national team where they are world champions, you know. It's very difficult to get in their squad, but I think he has the level. I have no doubts. And I also know very well the Scaloni, the national team coach, and I'm sure if he calls him, he will be ready, yes.
Has he called you to ask you about him?
No. We know each other because we did the UEFA batches together, we were in the same promotion, but no, we haven't talked recently, no.
As far as the squad completely, I think you gave them, was it Monday off as a reward after Arsenal?
Sunday.
How often do they ask for a day off, and how often do you say, yeah, go on then?
No, sometimes I say, not. I told them that even if we win Villa, even if we win City, we will be training next day, because they spend already the one they had, but normally we don't change the plans. Sometimes I feel like maybe it's good they have some day off, you know. These things you start to feel and you cannot do it every week. You cannot, there has to be a balance, but at least for the next weeks they've spent the petition, yes.
Arsenal, City and Villa in three back-to-back games like that is a daunting prospect. Is there any benefit in having them so close together? Are there any sort of continuous themes that you can run in training, particularly Arsenal and City seem so similar, but with Villa as well, does it help them at all?
Normally you don't want to have them in a row, you know, because you think, poof, I can be 1 month without points, or what happened at the beginning of past season, you know, you are playing all together and say, poof, when are we going to win a game? But it's true that the mentality, you have to be ready to suffer, because there are going to be moments where you are not going to be on the ball, they will push you are going to be defending, and it didn't happen a lot the other day, but for sure it will happen against Villa, against City in some moments, and you have to be have the mentality that we are not going to win every duel, we are not going to recover the ball every time we press, but we have to continue going next time with the same mentality. Otherwise, they start to kind of intimidate you, and then you get smaller, and it's a matter of time, no? And I think this mentality has to be very, very solid, very solid against these top teams, and now we have some of them in a row, and I think we can keep this focus, no big mistakes, no, you know, keep the focus 100 minutes, but it's more easy for me to say than for them for sure to do it.
And we've spoken about your set pieces. Arsenal are very good. Are Villa the best in the business?
For me, if they are not the best, they have to be close. They are very, very good defensively, offensively. They have a lot of different routines, free kicks, corners, everything. We have to be very, very alert. And they've also signed this season Onana, that is a big, big threat. We could see it in Everton. Straight away has started to contribute also in set plays with them. And I think we are defending well set plays, but it's true that it's going to be a big challenge because they are prepared for everything in straight deliveries. I think they've scored already 5-6 goals in set plays, no? So early in the season. So it's going to be a big, big challenge, yes. Thank you.